My name is Ashok Kumar. I am a professor in the Department of Physics, Tezpur University. Topic of today's discussion is electrochemical energy conversion and storage. First, there will be brief background on what is energy storage and why do we need it. This will be followed by different energy conversion and storage systems. The focus of this lecture is on electrochemical energy storage systems. So, we shall briefly discuss different electrochemical energy storage systems, namely batteries, supercapacitor and fuel cells. Energy has been prime input in the evolution of human civilization. From the Industrial Revolution, we know that there is direct correlation between energy consumption rate and economic development of a country or society. The global energy demand is rising rapidly due to increasing population and rapid industrialization. The global energy needs are expected to increase at the current energy consumption rate. It is expected to be double by 2050 and to rise to its triple of its present value by the end of this century. So, this high energy demand cannot be met from the existing energy sources by incremental improvement of the existing energy sources. We will have to develop new type of clean, sustainable energy sources. At present, more than 80% of the global energy needs are met by combustion of fossil fuels, coal, natural gas, and oil. These fossil fuels, their reserves are finite, they are fast depleting, and the combustion of these fossil fuels leads to emission of greenhouse gases and environmental pollution, having hazardous consequences for the environment, water and air pollution, as well as climate change. So, there is a need and there is a continuous shift towards renewable energy sources, clean renewable energy sources such as solar and wind, they are abundant, but these sources are diffused, dilute and intermittent. The power generated by these sources has fluctuation, it cannot meet the demands at the peak hours. Therefore, energy storage is essential if we shift toward the renewable energy sources to have the sustainable power supply. Other renewable energy sources like biomass, biofuel and hydro, they are comparatively better, but energy storage is required during their depletion time. Therefore, all renewable energy sources share the common needs of stable energy storage systems. Thus, energy storage is absorbing energy in some form at a time or place and using and releasing the energy at some other time and place. There are different types of energy storage systems where energy is stored in different forms, such as kinetic energy in the form of kinetic energy in flywheels, in the form of potential energy in pumped hydroelectric storage, thermal energy in solar thermal, pneumatic energy in compressed air storage, magnetic energy in superconducting magnetic storage. Among all these energy storage systems, electrochemical energy storage systems have been developed as reliable, sustainable, efficient and safe energy storage systems for different applications. From application point of view, we can divide all energy application broadly in three categories: this transportation sector, the vehicular transportation sector, where we need onboard power for electric and hybrid electric vehicles, for stationary applications including industrial and residential complexes, where we need to integrate renewable energy sources with the grid and in UPS and portable consumer electronics applications such as computing, cell phones, cameras, etc. And electrochemical energy storage can be designed for all these three application sectors. Can we design a giant electric energy storage system, a single energy storage system for all applications? The performance of an energy storage systems is determined by, is defined by different performance parameters, such as its power density, its energy density, its charging and discharging time, its response time, its internal resistance, long life without degradation, its lightweight, portability, and carbon footprint. We cannot design a single energy storage systems for all applications. We cannot optimize all these properties for all application of a single energy storage source. But we can optimize these performance parameters of energy storage systems for a given application. For one application, we can optimize these performance parameter through innovative breakthroughs. An electrochemical device essentially contains two electrodes, anode and cathode, separated by an electrolyte. The energy generating processes, energy conversion and storage processes occur at the electrode-electrolyte interface. The battery is a conventional energy storage device which converts chemical energy contained in the bond of an electroactive substance into electrical energy through redox reactions at the electrode-electrolyte interfaces. The battery is of two types. Primary battery, these redox reactions are irreversible. Once the battery is discharged, it cannot be recharged and it has to be discarded. Zinc carbon, alkaline manganese batteries are examples of primary battery. The other battery type is secondary battery or rechargeable battery. The redox reaction in rechargeable battery are reversible. Once discharged, the redox reaction can be reversed by applying an external power supply. The voltage given by a battery, secondary battery or battery, is determined by the chemical reaction of the anode and cathode materials. Its capacity is the amount of charge that the battery can store, and its energy is capacity into voltage. Different battery technologies have been developed for different applications. Lead acid, nickel cadmium, nickel metal hydride, lithium ion, and so on. Different battery technologies have different properties. For a battery, its energy density should be high, its cycle life should be high, its self-discharge should be low. Here is a comparison of different properties of different battery technologies. Lithium ion batteries have high energy density up to 200 watt hour per kilogram and relatively low self discharge, whereas nickel cadmium and nickel metal hydride batteries have high self discharge. Thus, we see that batteries have high energy density, but their cycle life is low and their shelf life is also low because of self-discharge, and their power density is low. So, for an application, if we need high power, such as for a vehicle on high up, going uphill. The battery cannot provide the power. It has high energy, but it cannot give that energy in short time. It takes time. It takes time in charging as well as discharging. Conventional capacitor or electrolytic capacitor, on the other hand, they have high power density. They can give energy, whatever energy they store, in a very short time, but their energy density, that energy itself is low. So, if you compare specific power, that is power density, and specific energy, that is energy density per unit mass of different electrochemical devices, the batteries and fuel cells are high energy density devices, whereas capacitors are high power devices, their energy density is low. So, there is a huge gap between the conventional capacitors and batteries. So, there was a need to develop devices which have moderately high power density and moderately high energy density. So, supercapacitors are such devices which have reasonably high power density and reasonably high energy density. Depending on the charge storage mechanism at the interface, at the electrode-electrolyte interface, supercapacitors are of two type. The first is the EDLC, electric double layer capacitance, where charge is stored at the interface, but it does not cross the interface. Charge is stored by the formation of double layer at the electrode-electrolyte interface. So, that makes its cycle life very high, but then its specific capacitance or energy density is lower than that of the other mechanism, where the charge is stored faradically, there is a charge transfer across the interface. This device is called pseudo capacitors. Their energy density is high, but because there is a charge transfer across the interface, their power density is lower than that of the EDLC type. But then their energy density is high and power density is also higher than that of the batteries. Lot of research is going on for developing high performance electrodes to increase the power density, energy density by developing new materials with new nanostructures, architectures, and nanocomposite materials to enhance the performance parameters of electrochemical devices, supercapacitor in particular. The other electrochemical device, that is fuel cell, it is a battery-like device which converts chemical energy of a fuel into electrical energy. But difference from the battery is that it is an open system. Unlike battery, which is a closed system where the active material, electroactive material is stored within the system, here the fuel flows across over the electrode, over the anode in the fuel cell. So, this is an open system, but here energy density is very high. Energy producing redox reactions occur at the electrodes, where often an electrocatalyst is required to accelerate the reaction rates. There are different types of fuel cell technologies which have been developed for different applications depending on the electrode reactions and the electrolyte and the fuel used. Alkaline fuel cells are the high efficiency fuel cells, but their running cost is high. They are used specifically for space applications. The proton exchange membrane fuel cell, their maintenance cost is low, their they operate at relatively low temperature. Direct methanol fuel cell, it's a version of proton exchange membrane fuel cell where the fuel is hydrogen. DMFC, direct methanol fuel cell, fuel is methanol. Phosphoric acid fuel cell, molten carbonate fuel cell MCFC, solid oxide fuel cell SOFCs. The PFC, MCFC and SOFC are particularly suited for integration with the microgrids. If you compare the different parameters of different fuel cell technologies, this slide compares different characteristics and electrolyte and charge carriers, operational temperature and efficiency of different fuel cell technologies. This slide also shows different ions that cross the electrodes and different redox reactions occurring at the electrode electrolyte interfaces in different fuel cell technologies. So, finding sufficient supplies of clean energy for future is society's one of the most daunting challenge. Use of fossil fuels must be reduced for a sustainable future for environmental, emerging environmental ecological concern. Substitution of fossil fuels by electricity generated from diverse renewable sources is a viable alternative, but these sources, the energy generated from these renewable sources must be reduced in cost and enhanced in reliability. The development of stable energy storage technology is essential and is one of the key challenges in the 21st century. So, to conclude, energy storage is essential in the whole energy chain and is at the core of decarbonization of energy systems. New generation of powerful electrochemical energy storage energy sources will rejig the power grid. It will usher in an electrically powered transportation and flexibility of electricity banks that can accept deposits and withdrawal of energy at any time. Large scale application of electrochemical energy conversion and storage systems such as batteries, supercapacitor and fuel cell is hampered by their high cost, durability and safety linked to the design and development of high performance electrode, electrocatalyst and electrolyte materials. Thank you.